إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فقد فاز المتقون وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his divine support, we shook hands yesterday, saying goodbye to a year that left us, to extend our other hand, to welcome a new year that came into us so that we can use it as a trend of peace to grow through this violent ocean of life and land safe before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us His divine support to pray 5 times a day for a year, to pay zakat for that year, and fast Ramadan of that year, and perform the Hajj of that year. It is a blessing. And with this new feeling, entering a new womb or world of iman, with this new beginning and with this new place, the place that is becoming new because a star will shine. For those in the heaven, they will see a new star. And every mosque on earth seems like that for those who live in the heaven, the malaika. A masjid, a house that Allah claimed to Himself. Baitullah, a new place that will give birth to new people, inshallah. And with receiving the new people who just returned from Baitullah, from the Kaaba, from the place that every eye, once they see it for the first time, they cannot help it. They cry. For some people, it was the first time, and for others, the second, and for others, more, to come back home as a new person. And everything in this life is a lesson. But for those who are seeking to learn from everything, in everything we look, we see something telling us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made me. And whatever we look at, It depends. What do we use to see things on its reality? One of the hadith who came back, and the lesson I learned, and whoever heard it, after making a decision in Mecca, or before entering Mecca, and the lesson we learned from that, new soul is that he made his decision before he put his ihram, no matter what happens to me over there, I will never ever get angry. What that mean? Places make people make a new decision. And what we see, and what we hear, and that is the meaning of studying something. We don't just read, but we study. We all can read, but only when we study. Hajj, study Salat, study fasting, and Zakat, and the Shahada, then and only then it will become a vehicle that will take us to where we're supposed to be. Then and only then we can be the man and woman whom Allah intended us to be when He decided to create us. He intended something great. He intended that we will represent Him on earth. He did not tell the malaika to do that. So we are chosen by Him to play this role. With the new people among us, and the new place, and the new year, inshallah, we also want to renew our iman, and renew our brotherhood. And this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, all you who believe, it is a comment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to those who believe. To people who left the darkness of shirk and paganism behind their back and moved into the light of iman and they want to make it real, Allah is talking to those people. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. O you who believe, remain dutiful to Allah and die not unless on the state of Islam. And that is the only purpose of being a Muslim, to be able to die with Islam. And one way to help our Islam to be strong is when we hold on together to the rope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down for us to hold in order to be saved. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Hold on strongly and together to the rope of Allah, the Quran. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And do not divide among yourselves. Be together in this. And if there is true Islam in me, I will be able to live with any other Muslim because you are holding the same rope. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And remember the ni'mah, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His favor that He gave you, He bestowed you upon you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً. You used to be enemies to each other. Tribalism used to make you fight. Color make you fight and think that you are better. Being rich or poor used to divide you. And other reasons. When somebody will say, I am better than you because of this. But a true Muslim will never say to another Muslim, I am better than you. Because Allah said, don't do that. وَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Do not be self-righteous men or women. Allah knows who you are. And He will tell you who you are. وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها. The lifestyle you could lead without Islam, which you used to live until Islam came into our life and we accepted it, that lifestyle put you on the pit or the edge of fire, suffering. And then Allah saved us from that with Islam. And He made His signs very clear to us so that we can be guided simply by following His divine teaching. It is a blessing of the brotherhood, the good one, which made Umar bin Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, used to say, لَوْلَا ثَلَاثٌ لَمَا أَحْبَبْتُ الْحَيَاةِ. If not because of three things, it is not worthy to live in this world. In another word, for three reasons, it is worthy to be alive. In the opinion of Umar bin Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, who knew what life was all about. And one of the things he mentioned, وَالْجُلُوسُ إِلَىٰ إِخْوَىٰ يَنْتَقُونَ أَطَيِّبَ الْكَلِمْ كَمَا يُنْتَقَىٰ أَطَيِّبُ الثَّمَرْ. Sitting with people, whatever you hear from them is beautiful, something that will make your iman grow. They will help you grow with iman. They only choose the beautiful good words to say, the way they choose the beautiful fruits to eat. None of us will ever pick up a rotten fruit and leave the good one. The same thing, we can create a healthy brotherhood when we learn how to talk to each other. When we talk to each other in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and remember the saying of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam when he said, you will never be able to attain the level of iman. And if you really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the day of judgment, فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَسْمُتْ. Practice your nature, and your nature is to be silent. Stay like that. If you cannot say something good, say something good or remain silent. It is a blessing to have this type of brotherhood. And what made us together is Islam. And Imam Ibn Taymiyyah used to say, brotherhood in Allah should be like this. مَثَلُ الْأُخُوَّةِ فِي اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ الْيَدِ وَالْعَيْنِ إِذَا دَمَعَتِ الْعَيْنِ مَسَحَتِ الْيَدُ دَمْعَهَا وَإِذَا تَعَلَّمَتِ الْيَدِ بَكَتِ الْعَيْنِ لِأَجْلِهَا. The brotherhood in Allah is supposed to be like this, like the relation between the eye and the hand. When the eye cries, the hand will wipe the tears away. And when the hand is aching, the eye will cry for it. This is an example of true brotherhood in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this new year, with entering Muharram alive, we have a new journey to go through. And we will remember in this new year where we came from and where we are going to. And where we came from, the womb of our mother. And where we are going to, the womb of the earth. From the womb of the mother, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ensured for us a firm resting place, who transformed us from a sperm mixed with ovum into a cell of life. Who did that? Allah. And then formed us from that into a clot. Who did that? Allah. And then into embryo. And then into a fetus. And then made it easy for us to get out of that womb into this world. thumma sabila yasara. He made it difficult for the man and difficult for the child to make it into this world, but in an easy way. Why it is easy? Because without his permission, the mother cannot get us out, and we cannot make our way out. Allah made that when it is due to do so. And then he opened the means of rizq and provision for us, everywhere and everyhow. So someone who did this for us in that place will never ignore us in this place too. Worms eat, birds eat, bees eat. We also can eat them from the same provider. But in that dark and narrow place from where we came from, there was only one channel for us to leave. We didn't make it. It was not our choice either. It was Allah's choice, and he made that rope of life, the umbilical cord, the cord of life. Through that we lived, by the divine support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made it for us when we could make it not for ourselves. And we stayed in that place for 9 months, or less or more, until we made it out here to accomplish a mission. But Allah knows, none of us can take charge of our post as a man or woman to fulfill the responsibility Allah lay on us if we don't trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But from that place, we have been looked after. This year will remind us then with the place where we are going, the other womb, the womb of the earth. And in there, Allah will not make for us the sacred rope of life, the umbilical cord. We have to take it with us now, with us, when we are in the second womb. From darkness of the mother's womb to the darkness of the earth's womb. But this time, we have to take our provision with us. We have to take our food with us. We have to take our light with us. Our life with us. Our peaceful life with us. And what that will be? The 5 daily salat, if it was alive. And the zakah, the fasting, the hajj, the shahada, if these 5 were successful vehicle to take us to be Muslims. These are pillars, and pillars are holding something on top of it, and we call that Islam. Not the pillars. The pillars are vehicle to take us to Islam when we end up being someone who Allah is pleased with. So with this new year, we decide to live our life and live it well. And we decide to let everyone who meet us, you will meet a new human being who will hurt you no more, who will say bad to you no more. And we will be glad to do that and continue to do it until we can do it no more, only when we die. With this new year, inshallah, a new place, and new people just came back from Hajj, a new committee who decided, some of them decided to continue serving. And we all know that the real masters of any nation are those people who are serving the nation. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said it, Sayyidul Qawmi Khadimuhum. When you see a group of people who is serving them, that is a leader. A new team move in to create a legacy. So when they are gone, we can say, this man did that, that woman did that, and so on. And we try to follow their footsteps. And while they are serving us, they will make mistakes, as we do make mistakes. All of us, we have the right to make mistakes. That is our nature. And from these mistakes, we will learn how to grow. We want to grow together in peace. One peace, not in pieces, not divided. So that when we lie down in our graves, people will say to us, rest in peace, not in pieces. But if we fight the community, divide them, we will rest in pieces in that grave, in the dark second womb of the earth, when we have no source of life. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspire all of us to say, I want to be part of it. I want to serve. And the only way to enjoy our life is when we become people of service. And those people who are serving, not because they don't have other jobs to do, but because they want to grow big. And how one can grow big? When everybody will look around and say, thank you for serving us. Thank you for being there. And so on. Musa alayhi salam, one day, when he was on the run from Fir'aun, and he was in a place, nobody knows him, and he knows nobody. And he found opportunity to do something good, and he did it. What was that? He just helped two lonely ladies. He didn't know them. He didn't even know one day the service you have done to that woman, she will end up being your wife. He never knew that. He never thought of it. But he practiced his nature. So he helped these ladies, and then he said, فَسَقَالَهُمَا ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الذِّكْ فَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنْزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. And what he has done, helping these two ladies with water, Allah made it in the Quran to remind everybody, when you see what you can do, you do it. You know that person or you don't. Practice your nature. And that's what Islam is all about. Islam has nothing to do with reverting or converting. You are just practicing the nature under which you have been created. It's to obey and follow it. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa ja'alana wa iyyakum min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه اللهم أحسن ختامنا وأخرجنا من الدنيا مسلمين اللهم انتصر للمستضعفين في كل مكان وعليك بالتقاة الظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين As I will enter this month of Muharram, every time we are not 100% when exactly is the first day. But by next Friday, inshallah, we will come to know who is the local Hilal committee in Australia or overseas in whatever way, so that we know what is the only sunnah the Prophet Muhammad told us to do when we enter this month. It is to do with fasting, the day number 10 of this month. That is the practice of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and that what we decided to do, to follow and practice the agreed upon Islam to keep us united. I don't blame my cult or my culture or my way of thinking, and we start to be divided due to a culture. But if you say on the agreed upon Islam, which we call Hablullah, the rock of Allah, the Sirat al-Mustaqim, before we add into it or we take out of it, that will always keep us united, inshallah. Wa aqim as-salat.